New Year's promises. I am a teacher and a lover of wild places, and I make these promises to my students. I insist that you always see the face, the strained sweat on the chin of the boy crossing the border in a boxcar, the confusion in the eyes of the caribou approaching the pipeline with her calf, the trapped terror of the car thief about to be raped in his cell, the 16-year-old handcuffed while registering, his stricken mother pleading with the guard. I insist that you risk seeing these faces, no matter where they insist you go. This is a lot to risk. I have no maps for where you're going. And there's more, for I am a lover of wild places, places that hold the untamed parts of our hearts, yours and mine. I ask you to look until you see the fragile lichen clinging to an Arctic hillside, the glint of thin sun on a grizzly's blonde coat, caribou rollicking over the tussocks, a wolf, regal and distant, tracking the herd, razored peaks silhouetted in blazing pink at 2 a.m., the clear water of the Nigu pummeling down the valley floor, a relentless, searing sun on the treeless tundra. Hundreds and hundreds of unbroken miles, miles and lives we haven't yet slashed to pieces. I ask you to think about what loss means, why everything depends on our saving these places, places that hold the untamed parts of our hearts, yours and mine. I have no maps for where you're going. I ask you to think on these things. The thought police have been pounding us. We hear the words, new words or old words redefined. Patriot, homeland security, axis of evil, terrorism, enemy combatant, collateral damage, alien. But I insist that you ask what is behind those words. What if a patriot is someone who fights against thought police and unjust wars? What if homeland security is love and compassion? What if the axis of evil is domination and greed? What if terrorism is winter and no food, illness and no medicine? What if an enemy combatant is someone who torches the fields and holds the patent on the medicine? What if collateral damage is the torn and bloodied face of a child? And what if there is no such thing as an alien? The thought police have been pounding us, and we have no maps. But I ask you to break out of prison, run like hell, don't stop until you find the truth. I promise I will ask this, and I promise I will not succumb to fear. I will not succumb to fear. I will not succumb to fear. But what you guys have done does matter to me. And you know that the journal you gave me is going to be right up there with journals I've kept in terms of, you know, where I put it and how often I look at it and stuff like that.
Why don't you feel like that you've done what your poem says? To me, that describes your work perfectly.
Because I'm not Robin Williams.
You don't claim that you're going to change everything and change the world. You promise them that you'll make them look at it. And
yeah,
I think you do that in your curriculum.
Well, this is true, I do.
Constantly.
How effectively I do it varies. But it's true, I do.
Well,
I can't help myself.
And you do not succumb to fear.
No.
So.
I mushed from Point Barren through a blizzard of snow. Been out prospecting for 2 years or so. Pulled into Fairbanks, the city was a boom. So I took a little stroll to the Red Dog Saloon. As I walked in the door, the music was clear.